Hello everyone, welcome to Reptile Ridge. Previously, this little skink came around while I was fishing in the Alabama River, a favorite pastime. Yes, I was reeling in some nice catfish, but I threw them all right back in, because I don't eat fish. I practice catch and release. Meanwhile, this little creature continued to hang out, basking on a small tree trunk. It's a beautiful, balmy, sunny day, perfect for relaxing along the riverbank. This is a young male, but it's unclear as to his species. We have several species of skinks native to the South. I am sure that he belongs to one of two of them. Either he's a southeastern five-lined or a broadhead skink. When they're young, they look almost identical. Even the experts have a hard time telling the two species apart. After soaking in the sun for a few minutes, he's off to explore. And he heads straight for me. How cool! Well, hello there. Okay, you have a nice day too. During the spring, the breeding season, these animals become quite bold. They seem to show no fear. They are driven by hormones, the need to breed. The males are much more colorful during this time to attract the ladies. When they have their sights set on finding a mate, nothing stands in their way. There ain't no mountain high enough, or ridge in this case, or valley low enough, or a river wide enough to keep them apart. In case you're wondering, skinks can swim quite well. The little skink continued on his way and simply vanished. Back on the home front, another awakens from her winter sleep. That's Opie, my pet. And this is Mocha, also one of my pets. He's an iguana, one of the smallest species of iguana from Guatemala in Central America. He was acquired from a local pet store. I've had him nearly a year. He continues to do well, although he's not very tame, and I'm sure he was wild caught or not bred in captivity. From what I can understand, these guys are endangered in their native country. But this little guy is going to live a long time with me. Rest assured. Opie is almost 3 years old. I rescued her when she was a hatchling. She's grown into a large, healthy, and relatively tame adult. She's a southeastern five-line skink. And her first meal after hibernation, baby crickets. You can see she's well fed. Today, I'm going to visit the reptiles that live on top of the river ridge. So far, I've found a pair of eastern fence lizards. There's the female. And this is her mate, a big, handsome male. Fences are generally found around fences, of course, and the scrub brush and forest. It's prime territory for them. They thrive here. But sometimes, their stake on a claim, on a piece of real estate, is pushed to its limits. And not always by their own species. Others find living here desirable as well. A skink, rivaling the size of the fence, has come to try to claim a piece of the property for itself. This skink looks like a female. She may be seeking a mate, or trying to find somewhere to lay a clutch of eggs. It's a tense moment. Oh, I wonder what will happen next. Tune in next time and find out. Thanks for watching.